Okay, I'm back, guys. I'm in the middle of trying to work on a computer as well. So, let me see if we can continue this. Now, I've already pulled the paint out, and I kind of want to fix this just a little bit because I want this to be more of a peak like this. Okay. So there we go. Then we'll just keep that color there. So now, just bring that. See, I like that better. Now. And that'll just blend that. Now what we're going to do, we're going to mix a little bit of blue with white. Blue's pretty bold, so here we go. Wipe my knife off, and then go get some of this white, get a nice little roll of white, and we're going to come up in here, and we're going to just turn this like this, okay? Just kind of like that. Let's go ahead and flatten out a little bit more. Get another little roll of paint. See, I was doing that so lightly, I almost dropped my knife. That wouldn't have been good. Now let's come back with some of this dark blue. This is going to just give us some gives us some shadows behind this white. Okay. See, that kind of makes the mountain stand up a little bit. We're going to do a little bit more here. Here. like that. Now, that's just a quick little mountain. We're gonna take this brush here. We're just gonna tap here like this. Lightly tap. Just follow the angles of your mountain. So that gives it a little bit of misty effect down here at the bottom. And now we'll put our brush away. What I want to do now is I want to get me some dark color on my fan brush. Now remember, we're just using blue and black and white. What I'm going to do here is this is going to be just some trees. Just the dark blue. Give this guy a little friend here. Something like that. See, we got a nice little stand of trees here. Maybe there's another little one here. Okay. Now these brush, when you're using this fan brush for this, you're just kind of going back and forth, tapping right at the corner of your brush, okay? Now, what we're going to do is I'm going to come in here with a little bit of this white paint. I'm just going to pull that color right on out there like this. Kind of doing the same thing that I do with the mountain, as far as just easily pulling across. Okay, I think maybe there'll be a. Let's go ahead and bring a tree here. Going to be a little bit closer. But if you notice, I bring it all the way past that first area. So now, looks like you got trees behind this set of trees. And that's what we want to keep doing, is show different planes, okay? And you're right, I think we're going to have to let him have a friend here as well. Maybe we'll bring another one. Maybe we'll bring one right on down here. That little guy will be like that. Yeah, now we're getting somewhere. Take some more white. If you grab just a little bit of that tree, it'll let you pull a little bit of that color with it and make it it'll give you some shadows there. Okay. So that's looking good. See, you can pretty much do whatever you want here, but I think what we need here is another mountain. Because right in here, I think I'm going to bring this out in front of that other mountain. So we're going to take our mountain color that we started with there. And we're maybe going to put another little peak here. Something like this. So, same thing with the other one, just kind of just scrape it back off, get all that paint back off of it. See, this is pretty cool because now that I have that, I'm going to take my brush just like we did the first time. I'm going to lay it here, pull this out. So now you see it pushes this mountain back further than this mountain. And that's basically what you want to do, is just keep pushing that mountain further back. So now we come up here, we do the same thing. Just come up here close. Like I said, the hardest part here is me trying to hold this knife lightly and not dropping it on the floor, because I did have nice carpet a while back. I replaced the carpet. I had already dumped paint on my old carpet, so my wife would definitely not like if I did that again. So now, come up here. Kind of do that a little bit, so. I gotta keep looking at my screen because I need to see what you guys are seeing. And this one's just gonna be a nice little spot here. Maybe this will go on up there. Something like that. You flatten that back out, get some of this blue, come back in here, and just get some. Here. This will just go come straight out here. Something like that. Maybe we will bring this spots there. Let's get just a little bit here as well. Separate this just a little bit here. A little bit right here. Might be just a little bit that's keeping that So, and you can just keep going back and forth with these mountains. Like here, I think I'm just gonna go ahead and bring another little spot down here. And maybe this would just go on down in front of here like this.
Okay.
I don't know about you guys, but been getting some pretty rough weather around here. Let me know what you guys think. Now we can bring a little bit of this white, kind of just let it hang over this edge a little bit. And this is kind of, it's not really giving me a good place to stand back and look at this, but I think maybe there'll be a little bit of white right here on this edge. Okay. Yeah, that has a little bit of a ledge there, maybe some dark color behind it. The other thing is, I could put a little spot right here. Okay. And that's just a little edge of that mountain. Maybe where people can go up there, set and relax while the snow is falling. Let's go ahead and grab a little bit of that dark color, come back in here, bring this back down, yeah, just to get your, and then maybe a little bit here with this, the very small edge of this knife. Just that part of the knife, it's a little edge right there, so that helps you get into little tight spots. But the other thing I think that we should do, because this area doesn't really have really good clarity there, so I'm going to just take some dark color. I'm going to just come maybe right in here. Maybe there's a dark spot here and there where it's a really deep crevice. Okay, maybe something up in here like this. You see, you can kind of really make some deep spots in there. They will help other things show up, you know, like maybe back in here and here. There's some dark stuff just to make that look more interesting. So that's what I like to do, is throw a little bit extra dark color back into this picture. And you know, whatever you do, it just gives it more character, lets you see more depth in your mountains. So anyways, enough talking about that. I think we're gonna go ahead and go and try to maybe tap this bottom like we did the first one. Tap this bottom out. Even here there was, okay, just tap where we just did our mountains. just barely coming up. Barely coming up this way. Just as light as you can. And in here, I'm just gonna kind of give it a little bit more. That'll give us a little bit more mist right there. Now, don't forget, I have to decide how and what we're going to do with this top section. I think we'll go ahead and bring a little bit of this snow. I do like I did before and just bring some snow, maybe bring the snow on out here like this, okay, so you see now this hill coming back this way is going to give you a little bit more depth there. Bring that on up here like that as well. Okay, that's looking pretty nice. I think what we'll do now is go ahead and put a little bit of black with that blue. And I just want to come on in here. And we're going to bring a couple more trees up closer, maybe something here, just touch with the top edge of your knife, I mean your brush. So I got Mama and the Pop of Mama and the Baby Bear tree right there. Let's go ahead and put a couple more. And keep that black color going. Some of this white right on through here like this. Okay. you see, I've created another plane right through here, which we can pronounce that a little bit better just by bringing that up over here like this, okay? Okay, so you have a little bit of lighter color here, right in this area. And a lot of this might get covered up, so just bear with me. We'll go ahead and bring this paint out some more here. Yeah, maybe there's just another hill that kind of just comes right on down here. Comes out there in front of that like that. And don't forget, I want this snow to just break right back through here like this. A couple of nice places. I'm going to go ahead and put a couple more trees in here because keep that dark color going now. I'm going to go ahead and put a good sized tree here. Okay, now if you take a look, not only is the tree getting darker, but it also is, I brought it from here, but I brought it further down the painting, so it looks like it's closer to me than that. So just keep up with what I'm doing. That's the trick, is to keep bringing these items closer to us, okay? So, this area, there'll be maybe a another tree here. Let's just put a couple rows of trees here. That's just tapping with the corner of the brush downward. Will give you that effect. And then maybe we'll have one bigger tree that's just sitting here. Okay. Another tree do now is come back in with that white. We're gonna automatically grab some of that tree, the color of the tree that is. And we want that tree color to just be drug down here. See, you got this plane back here, you got trees coming in, this tree comes in front, comes down this mountain, goes up in front of that mountain. You got a dark spot there, so this plane goes across, and then you see this row of trees come across this way. So take this, so as you can see, I brought that plane right up in front of these bushes, which will really help with distance as well. So I think what we're going to do now is I'm going to I need to make something a little bit different. So let me do. This is going to be a special type of tree here. And let me bring some more of this white down here first. Let me bring some of this blue. Dark blue color, give me some shadows here. Okay, you have to get some color in here, so the see that deep shadow there, maybe a couple more of those shadows come through there. And that's just so that your colors will show up. Nice dark colors back there. I'm going to throw another nice dark color right here. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do now, get a lot of that blue-black color, because it's all getting closer, and I'm going to do gotten down here, you know, some of this color is going to be pretty dark shadows up here. I just let that go across there like that. Okay, so now let me show you what we can do to finish this up. Bringing my snowbank. It's gonna be out in front of this one. Okay, so you see I got some really nice dark colors. Throw some bushes right here. Some little grassy areas here. And like I said before, all I'm doing is creating different planes so that it looks like you're seeing a long distance away. So now all I have to do now is take my knife here. I'm going to scrape in a couple of sticks here and there. A couple of sticks and twigs. Thank you guys for watching. Until next time, I'll let you know how it goes with fixing this computer because it's gone crazy. Until next time, you guys have a good day. God bless you, and we'll see you later.